Just getting another point of view in, Akash Chopra joins us, Indian cricketer, opened for the Indian cricket team till a couple of years ago. Akash, just first thoughts on this performance. Are you in the cynical camp saying that this was a much weaker Australian team and also it makes India look better than it is?
Well, how does it matter, Gaurav? Because a win is a win, and winning an old series outright, whitewashing the Aussies, you have no control over the quality of opposition that you are up against. So you'll have to enjoy and celebrate the victory. So I think India has done well. So let's give credit where it's due. I think this team has done very well. It has outplayed the opposition in all departments. And we'll also have to bear in mind that we lost all the tosses. And tosses, as you know, in India, are of extreme importance. If you lose the toss, you end up losing the match more often than not. Or yeah, at least playing the catching up game. But in this case, India dominated all the way through.
Yes, Akash makes a very important point about the tosses. India losing all four tosses in the series. Australia batting first on all four occasions and not really even once, putting in a performance that batted India out of the test match. Akash, some of the individuals will obviously be in, started the series being under intense focus. R. Ashwin after a poor series against England, and Ravindra Jadeja, whose test credentials were being questioned, but silencing some of the critics with those performances.
Well, both of them have done exceedingly well. Ashwin, for one, has really rediscovered his mojo, because he was someone who was struggling for the last 6 odd months. It wasn't just the test series against England, the ODI against Pakistan, or the ODI series against England. He was off colour, but now he has come back to his own. So that's crucial for the Indian team. And Ravindra Jadeja, he's allowing Mahendra Singh Dhoni to play 5 bowlers. So that's another positive. But then here comes the cynical bit, that Ravindra Jadeja, for all the good work that he's done, I still have my doubts about his success rate outside the subcontinent. He's ideal for these pitches, these kind of surfaces. But come South Africa, New Zealand or England, I don't think he'll have a big role to play in India's test team.
And Akash, that's an important question for Indian cricket to start thinking about, isn't it? Because they will remember the 4-0 defeats in England and Australia. It is important for a cricket team not just to play well at home, but also overseas. And more importantly, it's a long period on the road. First South Africa, the number one test team in the world, then New Zealand, who do well in their own conditions, and England.
Oh, this is going to be the toughest test, because now everything is away from India. Like you said, South Africa, then New Zealand, then England, and that will test the strength of this side. So far, yes, at home we have done well in this particular series, and go abroad, you'll have a few questions to answer. Dhoni won't be batting at 6 anymore, so there is one box which is not being ticked. You still need someone who can bat at number 6. Sachin Tendulkar's form is going to be a big bit of a concern. Openers have done well in India. Will they do well abroad? That's another question mark. So once we go abroad, there will be a few questions looming large.
Yes, but those questions can wait for a little bit. In fact, those questions can wait till 7 or 8 months now, as Akash has been pointing out. The series only begins in November and December against South Africa. Thank you very much. Akash Chopra joins us.